we could be in a lot of trouble.
Don't mind me, just moving the old test chamber a little bit closer to me. Out of thought, maybe proximity to the test solving might give us stronger results.
It won't.
What was that?
Nothing.
Oh, sorry, I could have sworn you said something. Your little primate brain. I'm not actually in the room with you, am I? Technology. It's complicated. You can't hurt the big old god face. Are you absolutely sure you're solving these correctly? I mean, yes, you solved it, but I'm wondering if maybe there's a number of ways to solve them, and you're picking all the worst ways. No, that was the solution. Ah, what am I missing? Brainwave, I'm going to tape you solving these and then watch 10 at once. Get a more sort of concentrated burst of science. Oh, on a related note, I am going to need you to solve these 10 times as fast. Anyway, just give me a wave, would you, before you solve this one, alright? I don't want to spoil the ending for when I watch it later. Well, you just solved it, didn't you? I told you to tell you before. Why are you making this so hard for me?
Remember when I told you that he was specifically designed to make bad decisions? Because I think he's decided not to maintain any of the crucial functions required to keep this facility from exploding.
Was self-destructing, already fixed. Programmed in one last tremor, for old time's sake. One or two more tremors in there, just for fun.
Warning, core overheating.
I then keep his job, I'm not a monster. Ignore what he's saying, just keep on testing. Still nothing, let's keep moving. Sorry about the lift, it's out of service, because it melted. Might as well, give you the tour. To your left, you'll see some lights of some kind. Don't know what they do, but very sciencey. And to your right, something huge, hurtling to what?
Oh God, run! That's not supposed to be there! Are you alright back there? Here, I'll turn the beam off.
Wait! Oh no, that's not helpful, I don't know why I thought that would help!
After seeing what he's done to my facility, after we take over again, is it alright if I kill him?
Buck, you're alive! Great!
Yeah, just getting a test ready for you, obviously. Who else would I be doing it for? No one. So, let's see here. Exit, exit, exit. There is no exit. Not a problem. I'll make an exit for your test. There. Bing. Good. Perfect. On you go. I'll be honest, after you told me to turn that beam off, I thought I had lost you. Went poking around for other test subjects. No luck there. Everyone's still dead. Oh, I did find something, though. Reminds me. I've got a big surprise for you two. Seriously, look forward to it.
two are going to love this big surprise. In fact, you might say you're going to love it to death. You're going to love it until it kills you, until you're dead. All right, I don't know whether you're picking up on what I'm saying there,
yes,
but...
Yes, thanks. We get it.
Surprise! You solved it?
Good.
Good one. Good for you.
So, he's inexplicably happy all of a sudden, even though he should be going out of his mind with test withdrawal. And he's got a surprise for us. What did he find back there?
I'll bet you're both dying to know what your big surprise is.
Well, only two more chambers.
We're running out of time. I think I can break us out of here in the next chamber. Just play along.
Surprise! We're doing it now.
Okay, credit where it's due. For a little idiot built specifically to come up with stupid, unworkable plans, that was a pretty well-laid trap.
You've probably figured it out by now, but I don't need you anymore. I found two little robots back here, built specifically for testing.
Oh no. He found the cooperative testing initiative. It's something I came up with to phase out human testing just before you escaped. It wasn't anything personal, just, you know, you did kill me. Fair's fair. Well, this is the part where he kills us.
Hello! This is the part where I kill you! Had a bit of a brainwave. There I was, smashing some steel plates together. And I thought to myself, yeah, it's deadly. But what's missing? What's missing? And I thought, lots of sharp bits welded onto the flat bits. It's still a work in progress. Don't judge me yet. But, you know, eventually, I'd like to get them to sort of shoot fire at you. Moments before crushing you. That's what I'm aiming for. But, you know, small steps. Oh, and don't bother. No. Don't do that. Stand right here. Stand. Touch. Where'd you go? Come back! No, seriously, do come back. Please, come back, please. Okay, look, I've decided I'm not gonna kill you, okay, if you come back. Oh, just thinking back to the old times, the old days when we were friends, good old friends, not enemies. And I would say something like, come back, and you'd be like, yeah, no problem, and you'd come back. What happened to those days? But notice that you're not coming back, which is disappointing. Oh, I've got an idea! Yes, in your face, I've got Fine, let the games begin. That would explain the extreme... Ha! Was that your bullet-riddled body flying out of the roof? It was... Oh, those were the crap turrets, weren't they?
Yeah.
Well, no matter, because I'm still holding all the cards. And guess what? They're all full houses. Never actually played cards, meaning to learn. Anyway, new turret, not defective. Ace of Fours. The best hand. Unbeatable. I would imagine. That's right. Thank you. I see. Clever. Very clever. And foolish.
Spinny blade wall.
Machiavellian.
Was that your bullet, riddle bullet, flying out of the room? It went,
Well, no matter, because I'm still holding all the cards. And guess what? They're all full houses. Never actually played cards, meaning to learn. Anyway, new turret, not defective. Acer 4s. Best hand. Unbeatable. Unbeatable. I see. Clever. Very clever. And foolish.
Spinny blade wall.
Machiavellian.
No.
Well, good, good. Finally, a nemesis worthy of my vast intellect. Holmes versus Moriarty.
Aristotle versus Mashy Spike Plate.
Well, good, good. Finally, a nemesis worthy of my vast intellect. Holmes versus Moriarty.
Aristotle versus Mashy Spike Plate. Stay still, please. All right, stop moving. Oh, almost going there, almost going there. Where'd you go? Come back! Did something break back there? Oh, did it kill you? That would be amazing if it killed you. Hello? Oh, yes, all right, no, just had a brainwave. I'll be back. If you're still alive, I'm gonna be back. Don't die until I get back. Hello? Oh, yes, all right, no, just had a brainwave. I'll be back. If you're still alive, I'm gonna be back. Don't die until I get back. Did something break back there? Oh, did it kill you? That would be amazing if it killed you. Hello? Yes, all right, no, just had a brainwave. I'll be back. If you're still alive, I'm gonna be back. Don't die until I get back.
Too good for him. First, he'll spend a year in the incinerator. Year two, cryogenic refrigeration wing. Then, 10 years in the chamber I built where all the robots scream at you. Then, I'll kill him.
Talk to you for a moment, if I may.
I'll be honest, the death traps have been a bit of a failure so far for both of us. I think you'll agree. And you are getting very close to my lair.
Lair. Weird enough, first of all, I've said it out loud. It sounds a bit, ridiculous, really. But I can assure you, it is one. It is a proper lair. Deadly lair. And I just wanted to give you the chance to kill yourself now, before you get to the lair. You just jump into that masher, just there. That's a death trap. Okay, I'll take that as a no then.